Hello, Erling Barrae from Calgary, Canada. Welcome over here to my program, 7 Books, 7 Tips, 1 Hour. Today we're gonna give the episode number 3. Thank you for those of you that are writing to me and giving me some tips too. I really appreciate that you watch my channel. And today I'm from my car. I'm sorry, I always do it from my home, but I'm away from home today. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, just in case if I forget after I finish the program. And let's go today with the 7 books that I have for you that I've been reviewing during the week and 7 tips. This is about to help you to increase a little bit your IQ. You know, maybe you don't have the time to go to the library, or maybe you don't have the time to go buy books. Don't worry about it. Take at least 1 hour a week. Go to the bookstore, grab 7 books, check some pages, and at least take 1 tip from that book. That's what I'm doing for you. You can do it for yourself too. It will be very helpful for you. I have my notes over here, so be patient with me. Remember, I'm in my car today. I'm holding my phone with my other hand, and with the other hand, I'm holding my papers, but we're gonna do it today, okay? The first book that I wanna talk today, it's Who Took My Money? From Robert Kiyosaki. This book is for the person who wants more control over their money and wants to beat the average returns of average investor. One of his tips, I just took one, you have many tips on that book, is this one. Take control of your money. Win the game of money. He talks about the game of money, of course, in that book, but especially on each time. And he compared that with some of the biggest games in the world, in sport. For example, from 25 to 35, that's your first period. From 35 to 45, that's your second period. Then you have like a timeout for 30 minutes if you're playing any other sport, right? Where you have four stages. Then the third time is from 45 to 55. And then the fourth time period will be from 55 to 65. Then it's overtime. And then the game is over. So in which state are you today? He make you think with that game money plan. So it's a good book. All the books from Robert Kiyosaki are very good. Book number 2. I Wish I'd Known Before We Got Married. That's a wonderful book by Gary Chapman. He's a New York Times bestseller. His tip, before you plan your wedding, plan your marriage. This author has more than 35 years doing counseling to couples. A very good material. Third book, Living the Good Life by David Patch. Tip, the best way I know to stay motivated in fitness is not to chase perfection, but rather to chase good enough. In that book, he refers to 125 reasons to do exercise. It's amazing what you're gonna discover in that book. It is fantastic. I read it like 10 years ago, and this year I'm reviewing the book again. The book number 4, Branding 101 by Trump University. The tip, be consistent is the key to building a strong brand. All the books from Donald Trump are good too. I learned so much from those books. Book number 5, The 5-Factor Diet by Harley Pasternak. Tip, choose white meat which is leaner than the dark meat and remove the skin. This guy knows a lot what he's talking about. He holds a master on science in exercise and he has honors degree in kinesiology. Amazing book if you wanna get some good results on your diet. Book number 6, Click Millionaires by Scott Fox. Tip, work less, live more with an internet business you love. Internet business. It is so good to go to sleep and the other morning when you wake up, you check your bank account and you got some money. I have some digital books on Amazon and I get so happy every time that I find money on my bank account, even when I was sleeping. So internet business, it is a good one. The book number 7 that I have for you today, Finding Financial Freedom. Do you want financial freedom? Look for, work for, and you will get it. I will recommend you this book by Grant Leffrit. Tip, increase your monthly mortgage payment. If you are paying a house, pay attention to what this guy says. By increasing $200 from $805 to $1,005 per month, that simple change will save you more than $67,000. Yes, you heard, more than $67,000 in future interest charges. In addition to that, you will pay off your 25-year mortgage 10 years earlier. Yes, if you're paying $800 a month, just put $200 more, which will be $1,000 a month. Just doing that little step, you will save so much money, and 10 years ahead of time, you will be paying your house. Hey, I recommend you one more time. Take 1 hour a week, just 1 hour. Go to the library, check 7 books, pick the best tips, and you will be increasing your IQ. Thank you. Thank you for watching my channel. If this bless your life or this is helping you, please share these videos with other friends. Erlin Barraz from Calgary, Canada. My information will be down there. And I wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from my wife, Jack, and me and my family. Wish you the best, like always. Bye-bye.